First responders face traumatic experiences and emergencies every day.
You know, those sights and sounds stick with us throughout our life. So the more those build up, the more sometimes it starts to wear on us.
The first one for Northern Wake firefighter Lauren Deere.
I went on my first fatality call and I didn't know how to process it.
That experience led her to becoming a fire chaplain for the department. Deere spends time building relationships with firefighters, leading conversations after major incidents, and connecting firefighters to mental health resources.
The most important thing is just support from the chiefs of the department and for the firefighters to know that their department cares about them.
Beyond the call, Wake Tech's Dr. Jamie Wicker points to other stressors like lack of sleep, running calls in the middle of the night, and living with people you did not pick.
You can carry this trauma over time and not even realize it.
According to a 2021 CDC blog, firefighters are more likely to die by suicide than in the line of duty.
The thing that bothers me the most with that is these are our brothers and sisters in the fire service.
Northern Wake Interim Fire Chief Blake Wright says opening up about mental health has progressed a lot since he joined the fire service in 2000 and is something they stress to their new recruits. He believes Raleigh hiring a staff psychologist can impact departments across Wake County.
The benefits of what Raleigh figures out, it trickles down and we're able to access that information.